I know I'm very late for my December wrap-up, but better late than never, right? Hello walls, what's up? I hope you're good. So today we're here for my December wrap-up. It was a very good month for me, reading-wise, etc. So I feel like I need to film this wrap-up, even though I'm late and you maybe don't care anymore, but I want to see how many books I have read. I feel like I've read 15 books or something and that I had a very good month, as I just said, but I just want to, you know, archive everything and to just store everything on YouTube so I have a trace of what I have read. Not that it matters, but I want that to happen. Does that make any sense? I'm not sure, but let's just dive into it. So, according to Copile, yes, I have read 15 books in December and I have read a total of 5,175 pages. All the books that I have read were in English. I DNF'd one book in December, so that's something unusual. I will make a video of all the books I have DNF'd in 2021. I believe I only have DNF'd 3 books, so keep your eyes open for that. So 8 were 5 stars. Keep in mind that I read many books for Slavicathon, so obviously something that I really enjoyed. Then we have 5 4 stars, 1 3 stars, and 1 DNF. Let's start with the book that I have DNF'd and we'll go up till the very 5 stars. Till the very 5 stars? You got it. So the book that I DNF'd is Midnight in Everwood. I was reading it for the Enchanted Book Club. I was just not interested in it, like from the very beginning. No, that's a lie. At the very beginning, I was intrigued because it is a retelling of Nutcracker. And you know, it had that wintry setting. And also it is a portal fantasy, one of my favorite subgenre, obviously. But I was like really intrigued at the very beginning because I didn't know where it was going. I was intrigued by the toy maker. I was intrigued by the family or whatever. But I never really cared for the Cracker, just because I never really related to them and connected to them because they were just for me one-dimensional. I couldn't understand them. And I feel like when a book is a portal fantasy, the portal aspect of the book should be not especially at the very beginning of the book, but somewhere in there. And I feel like it's only halfway through the book that you went through that portal, and I was really disappointed from that point still when I DNF'd. So I gave up. I don't believe it was a bad book, but I believe that you can really feel that it is a debut adult novel because the author actually is apparently really good with middle grades, and it was their first take in like adult fantasy. It really felt very young. Like I felt like I was reading like YA. I wasn't even sure at one point that it was adult, but that's not an issue itself, but that's not something that I was looking forward to in the book. So I DNF'd it because I was bored. But if you loved it, many people loved it, I'm happy for you. Then the only 3 stars that I have is for this book, which I was reading for the Sprintathon hosted by Press. I really had a hard time connecting to the characters, connecting to the story, and just caring in general, because I feel like this one was a build-up, like a setup for the series and the next book, etc. And I had just a hard time connecting to it. And I was like a bit bored. I really, like, every time I put the book down, I didn't want to pick it up again. So I had a hard time, but I still enjoyed it, kind of, because I'm curious to see where it's going. So it's not like it's a 3 stars. I'm like, huh, okay, that wasn't bad, but I'm not intrigued. I'm still intrigued and I want to understand the hype. Also something that happened in the second chapter or the first chapter I just was not prepared for, and that's kind of giving you like a essence of the book, like a tiny little thing that you, that is giving you like the vibe of the book, if that makes any sense. And I did not enjoy it. I was not prepared for it and I was really mad. Like when I'm telling you that I was mad, I was mad. I really was mad, like angry. But yeah, everyone is apparently loving this book, so I'm looking forward to the second one. If I don't like the second one, I will give up that series because I have to learn to give up series or whatever. But I tried and it's beautiful writing. I just was a bit bored. So I think that the second one will be better. I gave it 4 stars. I was hesitant at the very beginning between like 3 stars and 4 stars or whatever, but I really love the Russian inspired in this book because it's not like Russian folklore inspired. It has just the Russian folklore incorporated it. It's not like you're retelling or whatever, but you have Baba Yaga, for instance, you have references to the Firebird, etc. And I really enjoy the wintry setting. I read Beyond the Darkened Shore by the same author and I really enjoyed it. I love this one just a bit less than the first one, maybe because I was less surprised, or maybe because like I'm moving away from YA and I was still very intrigued by this one. So Through the Whitewood, I would definitely recommend if you're looking for something with like a quest, an adventure, like a magic system, something forbidden, and a bit of a Russian folklore. So yeah. The Snow Child, which is a retelling of Snegurochka, I really, really did enjoy that retelling because it is so close to the original, let's say, tale with some little twist or whatever. But even though I knew where it was going because I knew the retelling, I was still very, very, very intrigued by everything. It was beautiful. I was like heartbroken. I felt for all the characters. I was really looking forward to the next chapter, etc., etc. So I would really recommend that one if you're looking for something like beautiful and Russian inspired, obviously. Then there is a series that I finished in December. So I read book 2 and book 3 of the Winterhouse series or whatever, the first one being Winterhouse, I cannot even remember, but I really enjoyed it. So the first one was 5 stars, these two are 4 stars. I read them with the winter pack, so it was like a spontaneous buddy read going on or whatever with the first book, so we decided to continue with the series. We finished them, so I am happy about that. It's basically the story of a little girl who is living with her aunt and uncle. They don't really love her, but she lost her parents, so she has no choice than to live with them. But one day she's gonna go back home, see a letter, they'd be like, oh, we're going to on vacations or whatever, so you're going to the hotel for like Christmas and New Year or whatever, and she's not looking forward to that because it's Christmas, she doesn't want to spend Christmas alone in a hotel. But she's gonna get there and that's gonna change her mind. Like, the hotel is absolutely a place I would go to and I would love to live there. But yeah, lots of adventures, etc. I really love the first one, it was 5 stars. For these two, they were just like some things that were like a bit repetitive, and I don't like when some characters don't learn from their mistakes. And here I'm not talking about the kids, I'm actually talking about the adults. So that's why 4 stars, really, really enjoyable, really loved wintry vibe. I feel like in the second one, we get less of a wintry vibe, but really in the first one and the third one. So, yeah. And the last 4 star is this one, Vasa in the Night, is officially the most bizarre, weird, what the heck, retelling that I have read. It is basically the retelling of Vasa the Beautiful, like Vasilisa the Beautiful, which is like a Russian-inspired tale, and it is very close to the original story of Vasilisa, so Vasilisa the Beautiful, but not Vasilisa and the Power Horse and Ivan Tsarevich or something else. It is just Vasilisa the Beautiful. Obviously, you have other things involved in here, like Baba Yaga, etc. So it's I don't know how to describe the book because it was really beautiful, it was dark, it was twisty, but I really, really enjoyed it. But I'm not sure I was ready for how weird it was. I was really surprised, really not expecting it, but I loved it. But there were parts I was like, am I reading this right? Wait, does that make sense? What? But not weird in a way that was just like, oh, weird, doesn't make sense, I'm bored or whatever. But just weird because I'm not sure I understood everything. Like, it, but I loved it. I generally loved it. So, yeah. I feel like all the 5 stars will not be a surprise if you watch my vlogs, if you listen to me talking during different lives or whatever. But let's talk about this one, which is Russian Tales, a collection of Russian tales. 5 stars because I loved all the tales here, especially because I read it, so for Slavicathon, etc. But then I read this one, The Sorcerer's Spring, which is focusing on Slavic tales from South Slavic countries, so Bosnia, for instance, Croatia, Slovenia, Serbia, Montenegro, etc., etc. So I really loved reading these, 5 stars both, but the fact that I read them pretty much at the same time, so this one first, then this one, I saw the connections between some tales. They were pretty similar with a different like setting, with different types of characters, let's say, different types of tasks, but really, really similar. Even though I was expecting some similarities, I was still like surprised by them. But I would definitely recommend this one if you're looking for like different Slavic folklore and Russian folklore for this one, if you're into Slavic folklore in general. Then, not a surprise, 5 stars. I love everything about it. So I would highly recommend if you were like would like to try like some sci-fi novellas, very easy to understand, more focused on motherbird than like the science in general. Really loving them. Lock and Key, I love that house with magical keys. That's all I'm gonna say. I got the trilogy that comes after. Yeah, 5 stars, because I'm in love with that series, and I think that I fell in love with Joanne Gwynne. It's just an amazing series. Then we obviously have Dune, which is the biggest surprise ever. Not that I was not expecting to love it, but I was not expecting to love it. But I was so surprised by the political aspect, but the science in it, and the magic system, and everything all together, and the characters, and the shadowing, whatever thing, like everything was so important in this book. Within the same chapter, you will have multiple point of views. You will also have some text in italic that's the character's thoughts, but you also have some poems sometimes. You have like a quote at the beginning of the chapter. Everything is super important. It is a very dense book, but I really, really did enjoy it. I fell in love with it. I was not expecting it to happen. So these are all the books I have read in December, which is a lot. I mean, plus 2 books that I don't own. It was just like an amazing month, and I'm so grateful for every one of you who just followed my journey in December and helped me getting that motivation back and to be just happy about everything and to just have a good time. But yeah, Wolf, thank you so much for watching this video. I really hope you enjoyed it. If you did, give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe to be a part of the pack. Talk to me in the comment section as usual. And until next time, take care, Wolf. Bye.